The trouble in Stellendam started on the day they opened the new bypass road. Prosperity that had come to the town from passing motorists now drained away along the national highway to Cape Town. Even Stellendam's traffic cop couldn't write enough tickets to pay his own salary. What had once been a happy, bustling little community came to a sudden halt. The businessmen of the town were hard hit, as Stellendam threatened to become a ghost town. It was a serious state of affairs. The Member of Parliament for the district was asked by the mayor to attend an emergency meeting of the town council. And in the town hall, they faced the crisis.
How can I run a hotel without a guest? I've been here for 20 years.
Gentlemen, please, one at a time. Applaudy.
Mr. Mayor, sir. My petrol sales are down by half. Now, I say the only way to get those motorists back into town is to close that bypass road, government or no government.
Yes, well, that's one of the possibilities we're here to discuss with our Honourable Member of Parliament.
I've spent 5,000 rand on improving my hotel, and the next thing they go and build a bypass road.
Exactly, Mrs. Ichabod.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes? Oh, yes, of course. Thank you, Mary. And as our town clerk has just reminded me, ever since they opened the bypass road, revenue from traffic fines has fallen by 69%.
A serious blow to our treasury, Mr. Mayor.
Right.
I'd like to be knowing what the government intend doing about this, Mr. Mayor. After all, that's what we've got a Member of Parliament for. Heaven help us.
Well, Yvette, you've heard our views.
Gentlemen, there's an old Afrikaans saying which unfortunately cannot be translated. For any vapat, brantelach.
There's an old Irish saying too, and I'd hate to tell you what it is.
Gentlemen, this bypass road, like all bypass roads, was built in the interests of national progress. Efficient highways to keep the traffic flowing. Now, we mustn't stand in the way of national progress just because some of us are losing a few pennies.
A few pennies? Just listen to him. We are going bankrupt, and he says a few pennies.
The question we must ask ourselves is not, what can our country do for us? But what can we do for our country?
What will?
Oh, so we'll all starve to death. That'll do our country a lot of good.
Mr. O'Flaherty, there's an old Afrikaans saying which fortunately cannot be translated.
Yes, yes, there always is, Devet. Oh, look, we're getting nowhere. I mean, after all, here we are coming in for a crash landing, and all you've got to offer us are old Afrikaans sayings.
Which you can't translate.
The point is, Devet, what are you prepared to do for us in Parliament?
Gentlemen, Parliament is not the place to solve your problems. We must do it here in your own council chamber by using a bit of initiative.
What?
Oh, for heaven's sake, Fondemerva, stop haw-hawing. Gentlemen, let's face a few facts. De Wet, as always, is for his farmer friends of this constituency. He never does anything for the townspeople.
Why don't you try helping yourselves for a change? For instance, what are you doing about your town's 150th anniversary?
Mr. Mayor, if I might be permitted.
Murray.
We are, of course, very conscious of our 150th anniversary celebrations. We are going to hang coloured lights outside the town hall and a baby show in the square.
And a ladies' bazaar, Hendrik.
Yes.
And a fireworks display.
Oh, 150 rounds worth.
You see, gentlemen, that's what I mean. You're just not thinking big enough. What we need is national publicity, something to attract industry and capital and tourists to our town. In fact, what we need is a good public relations man.
Wait a minute.
De Wet, you're deliberately trying to avoid the issue.
I'm afraid it's your only solution, Buckley. And don't worry, friends. I know just the right publicity people in Cape Town to handle this. So if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to Parliament.
I'd like to propose a word of thanks to our Honourable Member of Parliament and to congratulate Mr. De Wet on the selection of his son, Fonny, to play for South Africa in the third rugby test on Saturday. You'll still go quiz with
him. Yes, good show, David.
Oh, thank you very much, Buckley.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Yes, I'd like to fly up if the Prime Minister can spare me.
Geluk.
Dank je, Hendrik. Hoe gaan we met Caroline?
Eerste klas.
Verlang zeker zo'n beetje naar Fanny, hè?
Ja, ik moet je.
Zo zaken nou staan, lekker van mij zeggen je hier of niet daar ook familie, hè?
Ja.
Well, gentlemen. I'll find the best public relations man for you. Tot ziens, allemaal.
Tot ziens, allemaal.
Yes, you can leave everything to me, Mr. De Wet. I know exactly the type of thing you mean. Yes, yes, of course. I'll put one of my best men onto it right away. I'll have him call on you. Goodbye, Mr. De Wet. Now, where were we?
Well, Mr. Matthews, you were trying to make up your mind whether to fire me now on the spot or give me one more chance.
Oh, yes, Larry. You know you're a good man. I would hate to lose you, but why do you always try to overdo everything?
But it was a great campaign, Chief. Sales soared. We had a 123% increase. Audited figures. And we put pineberry juice into the top slot.
Yes, and we lost out on the account in the process. 4,872 rand on audited figures. And you know why? Because conventional advertising media wasn't good enough for Larry Thompson. No,
You had to have a three-ring circus, an aerial display, and a mile-and-a-half-long procession through the streets of Cape Town. Don't you know that these things cost money?
Okay, so I don't have a money sense.
You haven't got any sense at all. You're always trying to blow up everything. What do you think this place is,
Cape Kennedy?
Have you heard of a place called Stellendam?
Yeah, it's on the wagon trail going north.
Well, I'm going to send you there. They want a job done in the town. Now, this is a small-sized budget affair, and I emphasize the word small. A couple of banners, maybe a baby show, or a couple of mentions in the press, you know, the sort of thing I mean.
I get the message, Chief.
Well, now you go across to the Houses of Parliament, and you see Mr. De Wet, the Member of Parliament. He'll give you all the details. And remember, no big ideas, eh?
Well, Stellendam, that shouldn't be difficult.
Ach, kom nou, Herman. Jy is die secretaris van die eerste minister, jy moet hierdie dinge weet.
Kyk man, Koos, daar is sekere sake wat hy nie eers met my bespreek nie.
Ek het 'n voeltjie oor vlei dat my naam genoem is, hè?
Dit kan wees, maar jy moet onthou kabinetsposte groei nie op bome nie.
Ja, is waar.
Koos, die eerste minister wil graag so gou moontlik jou menings oor hierdie sake hê, nê?
Nou maar goed, jou. Onthou daai sake, Herman.
Ja, reg.
Mr. De Wet?
In there.
Ah, Mr. De Wet. My name's Thompson. Mr. Matthews sent me.
Oh, yes, the public relations man.
Yes.
Yes, you caught me at rather a bad time. An important document to draw up for the Prime Minister.
I would rather I came back.
Oh, no, this will only take a minute.
Huh.
I want you to go down to Stellendam. Have a look around. See if you can scare up some publicity for the place. You know the sort of thing. Something to attract tourists, industry, and so on.
Ah, so it's national coverage you're thinking of, eh?
Yes, try and create a bit of an impression.
Well, is there anybody in particular I should contact down there?
Oh, I suppose you'd better see the mayor. Group Captain Buckley.
Buckley.
But don't depend too much on him. He's not a very enterprising type.
Right.
Put a stick of dynamite into the town. Wake him up, will you? You can count on my support.
Well, thank you, Mr. De Wet, and I think you can rely on me. I know exactly what you want.
Good. Minister van Landbouw, sir.
Oh, I'm sorry, old chap.
Good morning.
Good morning. Actually, I'm looking for the mayor. Is this the place?
Yes, but I'm afraid the Mr. Buckley's not in today. I'm the town clerk. Could I help you?
Oh, Mr. De Wet, you know, the MP asked me to come down and see if I could get some publicity for the town.
Oh, yes, he mentioned it to us. Well, I'm sure the mayor will be in the morning.
In the morning? Well, I'd hate to wait that long.
Well, is there perhaps something I could arrange in the meanwhile?
Yes, well, I'd like to look around the town, see what you've got here.
Well, unfortunately, I'm late for a meeting now. I wonder if you'd mind if I asked my daughter to take you round.
Not a bit.
Well, if you care to drive me there, we're just down the road.
Yeah, sure.
And that's the public library on the corner.
Mm-hmm.
It used to be the council hall of the old Stellendam Republic.
You mean this place used to be a republic once upon a time?
There were lots of them. Leidenburg, Huafinet. Stellendam was one of them.
Well, at least this place had a history, if nothing else.
Oh, I forgot to show you the caravan park.
I don't think caravan parks are exactly what I'm looking for.
Well, what are you looking for?
Well, I don't know myself yet until I find it, but it's got to be something that I can hang a story onto. You know, a gimmick. Something that the papers will really flip over.
You know, there is something that might just interest you.
Uh-huh. What's it this time?
Come on, I'll show you. It's at the museum. Hello, Percy. I've brought you a visitor.
Oh, good day.
Hello.
Here it is.
Well, what's this?
It's a document to incorporate the Stellendam Republic into the Cape Colony. I found it last year when I was helping Percy clean out the cellar.
Congratulations. It's a great little document.
The really interesting thing about this is that
Look, kid. Do you think we could go and see that caravan park after all?
Not before you have a look at this. Here, see? It's only signed on the one side.
So, it's only signed on the one side?
The point is, it was only signed by the governor of the Cape Colony and not by Stellendam.
History was never my best subject.
So if Stellendam never signed the deed of incorporation, it never became part of the Cape Colony.
Elementary, my dear Caroline.
So if Stellendam never became part of the Cape Colony, legally it never became part of South Africa.
Now, hold on. Are you trying to tell me that Stellendam could still be an independent republic?
Quite possible if they never signed the document.
Well, ring-a-ding-ding, how about that? An independent republic. This could be sensational. Oh, Percy, you don't mind if I borrow this, do you? I'll make sure it gets returned to your thanks.
Oh,
bye.
You can't...
What are you going to do with it?
We're going to press a few buttons and send this little town right into orbit. You are a publicity genius. Do you know that, kid? Is that him?
But I still don't think he's going to like your idea.
Look, any publicity is good publicity. Just give me 5 minutes with him.
Mr. Buckley!
He must be dozing.
Mr. DeVette warned me about that.
Mr. Buckley! Oh, Caroline, it's you.
Mr. Buckley, this is Mr. Thompson. He's here to do the publicity.
Publicity? Oh, DeVette's man, yes. Mr. DeVette asked me to call on you. Speak up, young man, I can't hear you. I've got a great idea for publicity I'd like to discuss with you. Yes. Well, if it's a good idea, I'm sure DeVette will be delighted. Shall I go ahead, then? Oh, Caroline, get your dad to attend to it, will you?
Yes, Mr. Buckley.
Thanks, Mr. Buckley. You see, the mayor's crazy about the idea. Come on, let's get to a telephone. Get me United Press, Sapa, Reuters, Associated Press, Agence France Presse, and the SABC News Department, and put them through as they come.
Mr. Thompson, are you quite sure Mr. Buckley approved of this publicity idea?
Sure. He said I should go ahead, didn't he, Caroline?
Well, yes.
There you are. He was crazy about the idea.
Yes, but I'm not certain this is quite the sort of thing we're after.
This is surefire publicity for your town.
Possibly, but we can't claim to be an independent republic.
Oh, but nobody's going to take it seriously, Dad.
Of course not. This is no more than a novelty item. Something to give the readers a giggle. Relax, Mr. Murray. I'll play the story down. Ah, United Press? Larry Thompson speaking directly from the Independent Republic of Stellendam. That's right, Independent Republic. Right, get this. Headline. Sensational discovery by town clerk's beautiful daughter. Got that? While on assignment in Stellendam, Larry Thompson, well-known Cape Town PRO and sports car enthusiast, was eyewitness to the dramatic discovery of an historic document.
Hoor ek hoe sy al vanoggend se koerante gelees.
Môre Herman, nee, nog nie eens oopgemaak nie. Ek is nou net besig om my lesenaar skoon te maak, dan klim ek op daai vinnige spesiale vliegtuig Ellis Park toe en dan gaan sien ek daai lekker wedstryd. Wat is die nuus?
Jy beter self lees. Jy sal dit baie interessant vind.
Is dit in verband met daai nuwe kabinetspos?
Nee, in verband met Stellendam. Hulle beweer hulle is 'n onafhanklike republiek.
Oh, is dit al?
Kyk hierso, voorblad nuus. Stellendam claims independence. Wat gaan aan in Stellendam? Mystery behind Stellendam move. New headache for Prime Minister. Uhuru for Stellendam. Wie eet hiervan?
Nie eintlik nie. Seker maar een of ander soort publisiteitsvraat.
Ja, dis wat ek ook gedink het. Totdat die eerste minister begin 'n vraag vra.
Jy wil toch nie van my sê die eerste minister neem hierdie dinge ernstig op nie?
Wel, hy het my gevra om daarop in te gaan. Ek het van vroeg vanoggend af twee professore in die argief besig en hulle kan niks vind om hierdie hele affære te weerspreek nie.
Hierdie hele ding is toch kaf?
Kan wees, kan wees. Ons hoop maar so. Maar hierdie saak kan baie meer ernstig wees as wat ons dink.
Ek sê vir jou, dis die werk van een of ander malaas hierdie, jy sal sien.
Ja.
Hallo, de wet hier. Oh, goeiemorgen, meneer de eerste minister. Ja, seker, meneer de eerste minister. Ek het net volgende na deur geblaai. Ja, meneer de eerste minister. Goed, dadelijk, meneer de eerste minister. Tot ziens, meneer de eerste minister. Dit was die eerste minister.
So het ek afgelei.
Herman, ek sê vir jou, hierdie ding is baie ernstiger as wat ons dink.
Jy beter opgaan boontoe en uitvind wat aangaan.
Geef my die eerste minister, geef my die eerste burger van Stellendam, dringend. Ek sweer, hy sit agter dit alles.
En laat my dadelik weet as jy iets uitvind.
Daai swaap van 'n... Hallo, is dat jou, Buckley?
No, I'm afraid the mayor isn't in at present, Mr. DeVette. This is Murray speaking.
Oh, Hendrik. What the devil's going on up there? Have you seen the morning papers?
No, they haven't reached us yet. Has something happened?
Enough for the Prime Minister to jump down my throat. Now you listen. Get Buckley. Tell him to arrange a full council meeting. I want an explanation of these damn things that are going on in the papers. Tell him I'm coming up straight away.
Well, where is the wretched man, Murray?
Mr. DeVette did say he was leaving right away, Mr. Mayor. Though I must admit he was rather emotional on the telephone.
Yes, well, we're not interested in Mr. DeVette's emotional state. The point is this kind of publicity doesn't do the town any good.
Let's not be too hasty, Mr. Mayor, sir. Now, if this document, found by Mr. Murray's charming daughter, is genuine, then it's possible, or just possible, I'm saying, that Stellendam is still independent. And then we can close that bypass road.
I object, Mr. Mayor. This kind of talk is sabotage, high treason. We are part of South Africa, and that's all there is to it.
Well, your Mr. DeVette should have thought about that before he started this ridiculous stunt with his public relations man up there.
Mr. Mayor, this is great publicity for the town. Front pages aren't easy to come by.
Young man, interruptions from the public gallery are not permitted.
Yes, sir.
Buckley, what the devil are you up to? Do you realize the Prime Minister's been on to me about this nonsense in the papers? You'll regret this, Buckley.
Don't you point your finger at me, De Vet, and stop acting like a wild animal in my council chamber. This is not Parliament, you know. Now go and sit down.
I demand a full explanation about this business immediately. Independent state indeed. Where do you think we are?
You behave yourself, De Vet, or I'll have you thrown out bodily.
Gentlemen, let's calm down and come to order.
De Vet, this is all you're doing. He's your publicity man, not mine.
Thompson, I thought I told you to see the mayor first.
Mr. De Vet, I did see the mayor at the dam. He told me to carry on.
No talking from the gallery.
I thought so. You authorized the whole thing.
I know nothing about it.
You know nothing about anything. If you'd stop messing around with your boats and get out of
here. If you'd stop wasting the taxpayers' money running around after running.
You're forcing me to lose my temper, Buckley. A thing I've never done.
Quiz, are you in your...
Who are you a fool for, Amara?
If we are independent, then there's nothing you can do about
it. So you want a little Bantustan, do you? You can't even run a town, never mind a country.
That remains to be seen. Meeting adjourned.
No, this meeting is not adjourned. Come back, everyone. Come back. And you, I haven't finished with you yet.
Mr. De Vet, you were the one that said I should put a stick of dynamite under them.
Thompson, get back to Cape Town at once. You're fired.
But what about the Sunday papers? There's still a lot of publicity value left in this story.
Thompson, if I see one more word of this in the papers, Thompson, I'm almost in the open matter. Wait, Tess.
Well, that seems to be the end of your story.
You may be right. Unless I can find another button to press.
Fokus. Jongen, het lijkt voor mij hier is moeilijkheid.
Wat is een moeilijkheid, Herman?
Die rechter-president heeft het met de eerste minister bevestigd. Wettiglijk is Stellendam een onafhankelijke republiek.
Wettiglijk?
Ja, die procureur-generaal heeft hier die document laat opstellen om Stellendam bij Zuid-Afrika in te lijven zo die hele zaak op te lossen. Hij heeft mij gevraagd te laten tekenen.
Nou maar, natuurlijk, dan kan ik hem tekenen.
Man, ik is jammer, jij mag niet tekenen, die koos die burgemeester moet omtekenen.
Hoe moet je die burgemeester moet omtekenen? Ik is maar die lid van jullie afdeling.
Ja, zoals die procureur-generaal daarop gewijs het, bestaan er niet een afdeling. En aangezien die burgemeester die gekozen vertegenwoordiger van die burgers van Stellendam is, moet hij dit tekenen. Maar, zien jou koos, ik moet die burgemeester zien.
Herman. Herman, wil je voor mij zeker niet meer een zetel in die volksraad niet?
In elk geval niet voor meneer Buckley die document ondertekenen.
Gee daar, echt zonder dat
hij... Koos, je moet hem niet ontstellen, hier moet je bij je fijn te werk gaan. Als hij niet tekenen is, ons niet diep in die moeilijkheid. Ja. Je moet diplomatisch wees, verstaan?
Ja, ik verstaan.
Your daughter should know better than fabricate such stories.
I can only apologize again, Mr. Mayor, but Mr. Thompson's a rather overpowering young man, and he did say to me that you'd approved of his idea.
Yes, well, I knew nothing whatever about it. The man's a scoundrel. We didn't ask for his services in the first...
Diplomatisch.
Diplomatisch, Gus.
For heaven's sake, De Vet, I thought you'd gone.
Diplomatisch.
Charles. I forgot to ask you this morning, how's Margaret?
She's very well, thank you.
Margaret's his wife, charming woman.
Oh, yes, I'm sure.
Herman, I'd like you to meet a dear friend of mine, Al Mayer, Group Captain Charles Buckley, DSO, DFC, and Bar.
Delighted to meet you, sir.
Sit down.
Thank you, yes.
Lombard's the Prime Minister's secretary. Well, he just dropped around to discuss a small matter with you. Nothing important.
What's it all about?
This document. The Prime Minister asked me to ask you to sign there, please.
Yes, but what is it?
Oh, it's just a formality, Charles.
Yes, if you'll just sign.
Well, I can hardly sign it without knowing the contents. Murray, look into it for me, will you?
No need to, Hendrik. It's just a simple document.
It's just to put this matter of incorporation right.
Usual red tape.
Incorporation?
Yes, still in damage to South Africa.
Oh, you know, Charles, this independence nonsense.
Mr. Mayor, it appears from this that South Africa recognizes our independence, and they would like the signature of the elected representative of the people of Stellendam.
You mean to say we really are an independent state? Caroline was right all along?
Yes.
But De Vet surely signed this. He's a member of Parliament.
Well, unfortunately, as the judge president pointed out, seeing that Stellendam is now independent, there is no constituency.
Oh, so you haven't got a seat in Parliament anymore, De Vet.
You know, Charles.
Oh, very, very. Did you hear that, Murray?
Damn funny situation.
Yes, it is, isn't it? Buckley, sign!
Charles. This is not a matter I care to rush into.
Buckley, sign that document!
I shall have to give the matter more serious thought. Gentlemen, as leader of the independent state of Stellendam, I refuse to sign.
But the Prime Minister said you must sign.
Convey my respects to your Prime Minister and tell him if he has anything to discuss, we can do so at a future summit conference.
But Charles, my seat in Parliament, my cabinet post.
Gentlemen, if you'll excuse me, I have affairs of state to attend to. Murray.
Yes, Mr. Prime Minister?
Prime Minister. Thank you, Murray. Murray. Arrange an emergency meeting of the town council for this afternoon. I will form my cabinet.
Yes, Mr. Prime Minister.
And Murray, see that the bypass road is closed. Immediately.
The crowd's going wild at Ellis Park with only minutes to go in this second test. First test drawn and everything to play for in the series. New Zealand putting on the pressure now. Inside the South African 25.
What's cooking, fellas?
The All Blacks are leading 5-3.
No, what's cooking with the crowd?
The Prime Minister's forming his cabinet inside.
I object. This is high treason. As a loyal South African, I'll have nothing to do with your cabinet, Buckley.
Very well, Fundamava. Since you are against us, we can only regard you as leader of the opposition. I must ask you, therefore, to leave this meeting. I shall form my cabinet without you.
All right. But I leave under protest. Scrape that in your arms up, Hendrik.
Well, now, gentlemen, before I announce my cabinet, as you are aware, Mr. Thompson here has helped to bring about the rebirth of our nation. In recognition of his services, I've decided to appoint him my press secretary.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister.
Public relations is most important these days, gentlemen, as I'm sure you're aware.
Oh, I couldn't. Yes.
Hardly necessary.
Yes. Well, now for the cabinet posts. Mr. Flaherty, you're the garage proprietor. I think you're best fitted to be Minister of Transport.
Well, thank you, Mr. Prime Minister, sir. And I'll see to it that that bypass road remains closed.
Good job, Flaherty. Mrs. Eaglebaum, you're the hotelier. Will you be my Minister of Tourism and Immigration?
It's a pleasure, Mr. Prime Minister.
Good man. And our schoolmaster, Mr. Rasmus, Minister of Education?
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister.
And who better qualified to be our Minister of Finance than our esteemed bank manager, Mr. Nicholson?
Delighted, Mr. Prime Minister.
Thank you for your acceptance, gentlemen. As for me, in addition to being Prime Minister and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, Army, Navy and Air Force, I will undertake the portfolios of Minister of Foreign Affairs, Minister of Justice, Minister of the Interior, and because of the shortage of ministerial executives, I will also undertake the portfolio of Minister without Portfolio. Make a note of that, Murray.
Yes, Mr. Prime Minister. Mr. Prime Minister, may I ask what my position will be now?
Yes. Well, we can hardly spare you from your duties as town clerk. Someone has to run the town while we run the country. So I should like you to carry on as usual, may I?
Oh. Yes, Mr. Prime Minister.
Gentlemen, the burden of leadership has fallen upon my shoulders. I know I can count on your loyal support in guiding the destiny of our beloved state of Stellendam. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you.
Mr. Prime Minister, may I suggest for your people gathered outside an appearance on the balcony?
Ah, yes, Thompson. We mustn't forget the people.
It's 10-9 to New Zealand. De Wet comes in for the kick. He kicks. It's a lovely kick. It's got the height and the length. And it's over!
Thank you. Thank you, friends. Friends, this is our finest hour. The challenge has been met, and we have triumphed. Today is a proud moment for us all. I am deeply touched,
by the loyalty and affection you have shown me here this afternoon.
Mr. Prime Minister?
Yes?
I think we should sort of ask you.
Oh, yes, yes. At this dramatic hour, it is fitting that we should pay tribute to the main architect of today's victory, Miss Caroline Murray.
Caroline, come up here. Come on.
It is her loyalty and her courage that has made possible the rebirth of our nation today. To us, she will always be the St. Joan of Stellendam.
So what's all this about?
Caroline found the incorporation document.
Okay, fellas, let's get the cheesecake.
Oh, there we are. Come along, will you?
I'm the press secretary. Anything I can do for you?
Pick some interviews, okay?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Swing it around a bit, Doc.
Come on, Caroline, turn around. What about a few full-figure shots to start with? How about this, huh?
Mr. Prime Minister, a statement to the people of South Africa.
Oh, they, yes. We, the people of Stellendam, desire only peace and understanding between our two great nations.
How about another one down here, okay?
I, as Prime Minister, of course, will not tolerate any interference in our domestic affairs. Any unfriendly act will be regarded as an unfriendly act.
Mr. Prime Minister, what is your racial policy?
The racial policy? Yes, well, we believe in equal and uniform development of all races. We shall progress together. Separately, of course.
So your policy is the same as South Africa's?
No, sir. South Africa's policy is the same as ours. Now, if you'll excuse me, gentlemen.
Hello, Larry. You're early.
Have you seen these? This is what a press secretary can do for you. You are now the famous Caroline Murray.
That's me.
Of course it's you. You're now the Joan of Arc of Stellendam. You've made the front page of every Sunday rag in the country. Look at this. Today, for 2 million people, you are a celebrity.
Oh, here's a picture of Mr. Buckley.
Yeah, that one slipped in somehow. But what do you think of the spread, huh?
I don't know whether to be excited or embarrassed.
How many people do you think get this kind of publicity? Nobody appreciates me around here.
It's just that it seems so silly, me being called Joan of Arc.
Silly? I have to project an image. And what better than you, the way you look?
Hello. Yes, just a moment, please. The exchange trying to get you. Mr. Matthews on the line.
Ah, it's the boss. He probably wants to congratulate me. Morning, Mr. Matthews. How tricks?
Thompson, I don't know which lunatic asylum you escaped from, but I'm sure that they were delighted to get rid of you.
Well, I appreciate you phoning to say so, Mr. Matthews. I take it you've seen the national coverage.
I sent you there to create publicity, not a new state. Do you realize the special branch have been on to me about this, and you've ruined my game of golf? What's more?
Well, I realize that we've captured the public imagination. And it hasn't cost us a penny, Chief.
It's cost me my reputation. Thompson, this organization is not big enough for the two of us. You're fired!
Well, I wouldn't rush into anything like that, Chief. Perhaps I could discuss it with you on my return.
Don't bother, Thompson. Stellendam needs you more than I do. The trouble with you is you're suffering from elephantitis of the brain.
That's a very nice compliment, Mr. Matthews. I'm sure it was no more than any good PRO would have done.
Well, don't stop now. Keep going. Why don't you declare war on South Africa? Why don't you get yourselves a king or something? Keep going, you maniac!
Well, thanks for the call, Chief, and regards to the wife.
Anything wrong?
No, just a routine call. As a matter of fact, the boss had a few very bright ideas. You know what, kid? I think you and I are going to press a few more buttons.
My deepest sympathies, Coors. It came as a terrible shock to all of us.
Thank you, Bill. It's a great comfort to have all my loyal friends around me.
To us farmers, you will always be our Member of Parliament.
Thanks, Bill.
Indeed. As leader van die oppositie in Stellendam, wil ek vandag 'n eed neem dat ek nie sal rus eer dat reg en geregtigheid geskied het nie.
Woord, stem sa.
That's a sort of stuff.
Vriende, ek is diep bevoor.
Can nothing be done to stop this maniac, Buckley?
Oh, no. We must be calm. I'm sure Buckley will sign this document the moment he realizes what he's been doing to me. We must handle this situation with dignity and understanding.
But what if he refuses to sign?
Then I'll beat that Englishman's brains out until he does sign.
Het jy al iets van Kaapstad afgehoor, Koos?
Nie 'n woord van die eerste minister nie. Niks.
En dit na al die jare van diens, opoffering en loyaliteit.
Dit is die diepste wond van almal. In my uur van nood staan ek alleen en vergeet.
Shame.
Go Telephone. The Eerste Minister will make you praat.
It's the Prime Minister. De Wet hier. Goedemorgen, meneer de Eerste Minister.
Ah, goedemorgen, De Wet. The PM here.
Oh, it's you, Buckley. What the devil do you want?
Well, of course, I thought you and I might get together for a little chat. How about you and Erica coming over this morning for a cup of tea,
A cup of tea? You've been thinking things over, Charles?
Yeah. Yes, of course. And I have a proposition to put to you.
Oh, that's very nice of you, Charles. In about half an hour, shall we say?
Splendid. I'll be expecting you. Oh, darling, I've asked the De Wets to come over for morning tea.
Oh, that's a surprise. I thought you and Kurtz were mortal enemies.
No, certainly not. As a matter of fact, in the interest of national unity, I've decided to ask him to be Stellendam's first state president.
Oh, in that case, I'd better get out the silver tea service.
Yeah, oh, darling, look, let's be especially nice to him. Huh?
But of course, darling. En wat het oor jou lewer geloof?
Ah, my lieve vrou. Binne 'n halfuur is Stellendam weer deel van die republiek.
Hoezo? Wat het gebeur?
Ons gaan by die Buckley tee drink. Buckley het op besinning gekom en hy gaan teken.
Wonderlik.
Kos gaan aantrek.
How pleased I am that you could come over, course. I know how busy you must be these days.
Oh, it's always a pleasure to see you, Charles. And Margaret, of course. Still as beautiful as ever.
Thank you, Kurt.
Well, you've got nothing to grumble about. I think Erica is the most beautiful woman.
Yes, but not quite as beautiful as Margaret.
Oh, nonsense. I think your wife is far more beautiful.
Oh, no, your wife is more beautiful.
Well, let's not argue about this. Of course, it's quite obvious that your wife is far more beautiful than my wife.
Who's arguing? A fact's a fact.
All right, we're both more beautiful. Oh. Now, will you two go into the library and have your friendly little chat?
Of course, we'll be in the library, darling.
I'll call you when tea's ready.
Thank you. Now, of course.
Well, I'm glad to see their friends again.
Yes, even if they are overdoing it a bit.
I know that in the past we've had our little misunderstandings.
Oh, yes, but nothing serious, Charles. One says things in the heat of the moment and...
Quite. And after all, men in our position have to overlook their little differences in the interests of national unity.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, I brought this document. National unity, very important.
You know, of course, I've been thinking. We've been friends a long time. Remember that last game of golf we had together?
Do I remember? But I was just lucky. I mean, you're a much better golf player than I am. Ben?
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Kurs. You know, I've been thinking, I'd like you to be president.
Oh, of the golf club?
Oh, no, you're joking. No, sir. First state president of Stellendam.
Now you're joking, huh?
Nonsense, my dear fellow, you deserve it.
Really? I'll think it over. Now, in the meantime, if you'll sign there.
What is it?
It's just...
This is the document of incorporation.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I couldn't possibly sign that.
But you phoned, Charles.
Yes, to offer you the presidency.
You mean you dragged me here just to make me your president?
Now, wait a minute, Gus. It's a very great honor.
But I already have a president. What do you take me for? A traitor or something? Erica!
De Wet!
You've got no principles, Buckley.
Oh, don't be a fool, De Wet.
You made me understand you would sign. Kom, Erica, kom ons loop.
Well, wat's verkeerd, Kus?
No, wil hier die Engelsman nie weer teken nie.
There was never any question of signing the document, De Wet.
Kom ons loop, Erica.
Ons het nog nie eers tee gedrink nie, Kus.
Ons kan by die huis gaan tee drink. Goodbye, Margaret. I forgot everything, my pen, my wife, kom.
I'll phone you, Margaret. Bye, Charles.
Goodbye, Erica.
And you said be nice to them.
I'll have my tea in the library. Well, there we have it, gentlemen. Our hand of friendship, extended to him in the interests of national unity, was scorned. Well, that's a matter between De Wet and his conscience. Our duty now is to look elsewhere for our state president.
Why don't you elect yourself president, Buckley? You've made yourself everything else around here.
Obviously, our ex-member of parliament has nothing better to do with his time than attend our parliamentary proceedings in Heckel.
You talk of national unity. What about our unity with South Africa?
De Wet, if you don't stop these infernal interruptions, I'll have you thrown out by our sergeant-at-arms. Down, Murray. Now, let's consider this matter of the state president. Our man must be above politics. He must possess dignity, integrity. and he must be respected by the community.
Well, that lets you out anyway, De Wet.
Mr. Prime Minister, I would like to propose Mr. Whitehead, our lawyer, as president.
Oh, I couldn't agree to that, Mr. Prime Minister. That man owes me money for petrol and repairs for I don't know how long. He has no integrity.
What about Mr. DeFloy, the estate agent?
Oh, didn't you hear? He's divorcing his wife.
Possibly Mr. Martin's the insurance man.
Oh, no. He's the correspondent.
Yes, well, we could hardly have our president involved in that sort of thing. Murray, there's no water.
I'm sorry, Mr. Prime Minister.
Oh, come, gentlemen. There must be somebody we respect.
Mr. Prime Minister, a suggestion.
Yes, Thompson.
Mr. Prime Minister, in your own words, we're looking for somebody of dignity, integrity, somebody we all respect. I think we have one such person, whom, in your own words once again, is the Joan of Arc of Stellendam, Miss Caroline Murray.
Thompson, you don't seriously suggest we have a female head of state?
Why not, Mr. Prime Minister? Look at Queen Elizabeth, Queen Juliana. They're females.
Really? Yes, of course they are, but I mean, they're of royal descent.
Well, there has to be a first of the royal line, Mr. Prime Minister.
Yes.
Thompson, you've caused enough trouble as it is now. Don't start any royal families in South Africa.
Let me remind you, De Wet, this is not South Africa, and we can do anything we wish. We can even have television if we want to.
No, you wouldn't.
Carry on, Thompson.
Thank you, Mr. Prime Minister. I'm not suggesting that we have a queen, but what about a princess, Mr. Prime Minister? Think of the publicity value of a princess. We could outgrace Monaco. We could become the smallest kingdom in the world. Something unique instead of just another little republic.
First class idea for bringing in tourists, Mr. Prime Minister. Oh, it's a lovely idea, sir.
Yes, why not? A charming girl.
We're all agreed on it, then.
Oh, yes.
Very well, gentlemen. Carried unanimously. Caroline, my dear. Or more correctly, Your Royal Highness, Princess Caroline. As leader of your cabinet, I pledge our loyalty and support in all the arduous tasks that lie before you.
Thank you, Mr. Buckley. But I think I should talk to my dad about this first.
Your dad will be delighted, Your Highness. Thompson, this is going to make Murray king, his daughter being a princess.
Yes, it would seem to follow, Mr. Prime Minister.
But we can't spare our town clerk to be king, Thompson. He's the only man who knows the filing system.
Another brilliant idea of yours, Mr. Prime Minister. Monarchy-wise, a new concept. A working king, instead of a monarch who's just a drain on public finances.
Very well, as long as it doesn't interfere with his regular duties. But where is the man? Murray!
Here, Mr. Prime Minister.
Murray, we've decided to become a monarchy, and you're it.
Oh, indeed, Mr. Prime Minister.
Ladies and gentlemen, the king.
Me?
Yes, you, Your Majesty.
Hold your water, Mr. Prime Minister.
Long live King Hendrik! Long live King Hendrik!
Passport, alstublieft. All passports, please. Declare all dirtyable goods. Anything to declare, no. Sir. Boltong, chewing tobacco, wet blitz.
I'm passing through on the way to Cape Town.
You'll need the transit permit for that, sir, at 50 cents per adult and 10 cents per child. That'll be 50 cents, one round 10, 20, 40, one round 40, sir.
That's highway robbery.
It's cheaper the price, sir, but haven't you anything smaller?
No.
One round 40.
One round 40. Come on, hurry up, will you? I've got a long way
change
to
go. Change coming up, sir. Change coming up. Your change, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Do come again.
That'll be the day.
Thank you, sir.
Come on, move along.
Right, sir. Move on. Right, sir. Anything to declare, sir? All passports.
Quiet! What do you think this is? A drive-in?
Quiet!
Don't shut up!
Wat maak je hier?
Morgen, schalk. Lekker geslaap.
Waarvoor al die draad?
Oh, is die nieuwe grens tussen Stellendam en Zuid-Afrika. Ons het laatst nog hier die hele grens hier toegespan.
Grens? En wat van mijn kleinheidje?
Jou kleinhuis is nou in Stellendam. Je sal met 'n paspoort wys as jy wil deurkom.
Maar ek wil net gaan. Verdomd, man.
Jammer, omskou. Al die Suid-Afrikaners moet hulle paspoorte hier wys.
En sê nou maar ek het nie 'n paspoort.
Nou my maak net totdat jy een kry, omskou. Hoor.
Hey, Freaky. What are you up to now?
Oh, I'm opening up this bypass road. Orders from Sergeant van der Westhuizen.
Well, I've got orders from my Prime Minister to keep this bypass road closed.
I don't care what your Prime Minister said. Sergeant van der Westhuizen says this road must be opened.
Well, you go back and tell your Sergeant van der Westhuizen that I'm bigger than you.
All right. But remember, you're obstructing an officer of the law in performing his duty, eh?
All right. I'll remember.
Kijk, Erika, ik heb klaargepraat. Hier is een nationale ramp en je wil partijtje hou.
Maar dit is niet zomaar een gewone partijtje, niet? Dit is een koninklijke bal. Buckley heeft ons speciaal genoeg.
Stel niet belang in Buckley zijn koninklijke bal, niet. Lijkt voor mij, je neemt hier die koning nonsens ernstig op.
Het is jij wat het ernstig opneemt door je weiering om te gaan.
Ik geloof niet door mijn tegenwoordigheid voor hier, niet.
Jij kan niet zomaar net zo uit die openbare leven treden, niet? Allemaal gaan daar wees.
Buckley heeft die uitnodiging net gestuurd om mij kwaad te maken. En als hij zo aanhou, gaan hij het recht krijgen, hoor.
Jij is net weer koppig. Hallo?
Goedemorgen, mevrouw. Is meneer De Wet thuis? Die eerste minister wil graag met ons praten. Dank je, mevrouw.
Koos, die eerste minister wil met jou praten.
Oh, hij wil, hè? Ja, dat is goed zo. Maar er zijn een paar dingetjes dat ik graag voor hem ook wil zeggen. Yes, what the devil do you want this time? Goedemorgen, meneer de eerste minister. Het is jammer, de eerste minister, hij gedacht was die ander. Ik zie toen Ila's gebeld was. Nee, er was niet iemand gebeld, nee, was. Ja, ik is jammer, meneer de eerste minister. Nee, ik is bevreesd, is nog niet getekend, meneer de eerste minister. Ja, ik zal mijn best doen, meneer de eerste minister. Ja, zeker, meneer de eerste minister. Tot ziens, meneer de eerste minister.
Oh, hallo, pa.
Ah, Fanny, mijn zin. Je is terug, nee. Dat is wonderlijk om je weer te zien, mijn zin.
Hoe gaat het,
pa? Oh, Fanny, die verschrikkelijkste dingen mee gebeuren van dat je weg is. Hij heeft mij die parlement uitgeskopt. Hij heeft nu eerste minister, zijn konings en allerhande stukke goed. Dat is hier bij mooi gespeeld, Fanny.
Dank je.
Zelfs mijn eeuwvrouw heeft hiermee gedraaid. Die hele dorp is mal. Ik is de enigste nuchter mee als het oorblijft.
Ach nee, pa, kan niet zo ernstig wezen.
Is, Fanny, is. Wacht, je ezel zien. Konings en goeders. Dus is ze. Wacht, mijn zin. Je zal zien.
Stephanus Johannes Jacobus Martinus de Wet. You are hereby commanded by Her Royal Highness Princess Caroline to attend a private audience this very day at the Royal Palace of Stellendam.
Dank je, Percy.
Alles mal. Heb je gezegd? Alles allemaal mal.
Hallo, Jap. Wat is jij verliefd?
The King!
Your Majesty.
I beg your pardon.
Ah, hello, Fanny.
Dag, oom Hendrik.
Ay, maar je hebt mooi gespeeld, uw zin.
Dank je.
Je weet maar, zal het mijn koning gemaakt.
Ik zie ze, ja.
Well, of course, it means a little bit of extra work. All this ceremony. Upholding the dignity of the royal house.
Murray! Murray, what's happened to the file on royal protocol?
Coming, Mr. Prime Minister.
Well, pull finger, will you, Murray?
Yes, Mr. Prime Minister. Forgive me, I'll simply Fanny.
Dag, oom Hendrik.
Good morning, gentlemen. Morning.
Who shall I say is calling?
Come off it, Percy. Where's Caroline?
Follow me, please.
Then there's a sitting for a colour portrait for the London Illustrated News. And how about this, Caroline? Time magazine wants an interview with you for a cover story.
Oh, oui.
Then there's a Paris match. They want a picture spread. And the BBC wants an interview with you for the third programme. What do you think about that,
Mr. Stephanus Johannes Jacobus, something to vet, Your Highness.
I was only expecting you this afternoon.
I came when I received your command, Your Highness.
Oh, that was just a bit of fun. How often does one get to be a princess?
We're just about due at the press conference, Your Highness.
Oh, I'm sorry, Fanny. How about this afternoon?
May I remind Your Highness that this afternoon you have to visit the nursery school?
Oh, I forgot about that. But this evening, then,
This evening it's dinner with Lord and Lady Chumley, Your Highness.
Oh, dash, and tomorrow morning's fittings of the royal garden.
And in the afternoon it's planting a tree in the village square. Let's have a look. What about Wednesday? Wednesday morning at 10 it's children's sports day, and in the afternoon a cake sale. Now let's have a look here. No, it doesn't appear that you'll have any free time until after the royal ball, Your Highness.
You know about the ball, and you are coming. It'll be a smasher.
Your Highness, the press conference.
I'll ring you, Fanny, and don't forget about the royal ball. Bye.
Thank you.
His Excellency Sir Anthony Smethwick, the British ambassador to the court of King Hendrik.
Your Majesty, I am commanded by Her Majesty the Queen to convey greetings and to tell you that if ever you're in trouble, please do not hesitate to call upon her.
That is most kind of her. And will you please tell Her Majesty not to hesitate to call upon me if ever she gets into trouble?
I thank Your Majesty.
His Excellency Henry J. Maxwell, the United States Ambassador to the Court of King Hendrik.
Greetings, Your Majesty. I want you to know that Uncle Sam is real proud of you. We, the President and the people of the United States, are sure that you will take your rightful place in the great society and in the family of nations in the world today.
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador, and the same to your Uncle Sam.
Thank you, sir.
His Excellency Ivan Petrogrovich, the Russian Ambassador to the Court of King Hendrik.
Comrade Hendrik, greetings from the Kremlin. We hug you to our breast as friends and comrades of the glorious revolution to overthrow the capitalist warmongers. We, the Soviet people...
Thank you, Mr. Ambassador.
Hail the revolution!
We better circulate among the people, Murray.
Your Majesty, His Excellency Mr. Herman Lombard, the Ambassador from the Republic of South Africa.
Your Majesty, on behalf of the President, Prime Minister and people of South Africa, I convey sincere good wishes.
Thank you, Mr. Lombard, and welcome.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Herman. Herman, hoe kom het hulle vir my nie hiervan gesê nie?
Wel, die eerste minister het besluit dat ons ambassadeur hier nodig het en toe kies hy my. Maar wat soek jy hier, koos ek dog jy steun hulle?
My vrou het my hiernatoe gesleep, dink jy ek wil hier wees? Maar Herman, ons eerste minister herken nie regtig hierdie gedoente nie, hè?
Natuurlik ja. En wat meer is, hy wil het diplomatisch gedoen, hè?
Diplomatisch? Hy moet een Wafraag soldaten stuur en die spul hier uitroei.
Ons sal nie in ander lande sy huishoudelike sake inmeng nie. Maar verskoon my nou, koos ek nog by die eerste minister aanmeld.
Kijk hier, Lombard, ek waarsku jou dat... Herman.
Be assured, gentlemen, my country seeks only friendship with peace-loving peoples. But we shall smite down those who threaten us. A drink, Lombard?
Now, a toast to freedom everywhere and an end to capitalist exploitation.
A toast to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, and an end to communist aggression.
Yeah, yeah.
A toast to the glory.
My general, chap. The Queen, God bless her.
A toast.
Toast, gentlemen, to the birth of a glorious new nation.
I think I'll ask Dad to knight you.
Thank you, Your Highness. But why me?
Because you're our national rugby hero. Let's see, what shall we call you? Ah, Safani of Ellis Park.
Erika, ons loop huis toe. Ek is nou dik hiervan.
Ons het pas aangekom. Ek het nog nie eens gedans
nie. Ons kan by die huis gaan dans, kom.
Good evening.
Your Majesty.
Are you enjoying yourselves?
No.
Oh.
Of course, isn't feeling too well tonight.
Ja, ek is siek.
I'm sorry to hear that. May I have the pleasure, Mrs. Devet?
Your Majesty.
I toast the new power station my country will build for you.
That's very good. Toast the new power station and an airport my country will build for you.
I toast the new power station, airport, and dam my country will build for you.
I toast the new power station, an airport, a dam, and a steelworks my country will build for you.
Jolly good. Mr. British Ambassador, what do you propose for?
Mr. Prime Minister, I toast a proposed cricket tour of Stellendam with the MCC.
Jan Skalk. Heb je paspoort gekregen?
Zo, zaterdag. Is jij Skalk Christian Prinsloo?
Dammit, je ken me, mos.
Tijdperk van verblijf.
Ik ga niet zo toe.
Nou ja, net 5 minuten hoor. Een plezierige reis.
Now you're looking for trouble, Fricky.
But Sergeant van der Westhuizen says this road is in South African territory. It's got to be opened. Look here. Written instructions. And what's more, that border's got to come down too.
I'll report you to my Prime Minister.
And I'll report you to Sergeant van der Westhuizen.
But Mr. Prime Minister, this map from the Surveyor General's office proves beyond doubt that the bypass road is in South African territory.
Never mind your map. Traditionally, Stellendam's border is in the mountain range, and you know it.
But here it is. It shows the river as the border, and the bypass road is beyond the river. I'm afraid my government will accept no other interpretation.
The bypass road is in Stellendam, and that's where it's going to stay. And I warn you, Lombard, these flagrant violations of our territorial rights have got to stop.
Violations? We're merely claiming what is ours.
Lombard,
Buckley,
I'm...
Diplomatis.
De Wet, how dare you bust into my office unannounced?
Buckley, I'm... Mora Herman, I'm asking you for the last time to sign this document.
Good heavens, I'll have you thrown out. Murray!
Do you realize that my son has been kicked out of the Springbok rugby team?
And do you realize I'm involved in international affairs?
And do you know why? Because the selectors say that he is not a South African. Oh, Charles, sign this. Let's incorporate so that Fanny can play.
I'm sorry. I cannot equate a game of rugby with the destiny of my country. Now, if you'll excuse me. Lombard, the bypass road shall remain closed.
I'm afraid my government will not share that view. We shall defend our rights. Your Majesty.
Gentlemen, you called for an audience with me.
Good heavens, Murray, another crown?
Oh, this is my working crown.
Oh. Well, throw this man out.
Look here, Buckley. You can make yourself Prime Minister. You can have kings and things. You can have me thrown out of Parliament. But I warn you, if South Africa should lose the third rugby test, there's going to be serious trouble.
Oh, I refuse to be intimidated by either of you. I shall go to higher authority.
What higher authority?
Murray, take immediate steps to join the United Nations. And you can tell that to Sergeant van der Westhuizen.
You know when I hear anything further, Mr. Genet.
Thank you. Good morning.
Can I help you?
I'm the delegate for the newly independent state of Malumbia.
Welcome to the United Nations.
Thank you. I was going to ask you to tell me where
Excuse
the office
me. Is. United Nations organization, can I help you?
Yes, please. We'd like to join the United Nations rather urgently, if it's possible.
Yes. What is the name of your country?
The Kingdom of Stellendam in Africa.
Oh, another independent African state. How nice. I'm sure you'll have no difficulty in becoming a member. I'll have your call put through to membership. Mind your ear.
9-5 in New Zealand's favour, and South Africa only need a goal to get back in front. And here they come, a scrum on the New Zealand line.
He's telling us, nige vijf in die gunst van die All Blacks. Twani de Wit speel niet vandaag nie, en er is uiterst jammer voor Zuid-Afrika. Die bal komt uit naar die toy toe. Een ver lang agie in die handen van zijn centers. En die bal wordt aangeslaan op die doellijn. Een scrum op die All Black doellijn. Briscoe telt prachtig op en hij skopt naar die kantlijn toe. En die eindvlek die plaats. Zuid-Afrika verloor die derde toets. Die neerlaag kan in een groot mate aan de wetse afwezigheid toegeschreven worden. En...
Gentlemen, this means war.
Mr. Prime Minister, Mr. Prime Minister, I bring you grave news, revolution-wise.
What do you mean, Thompson?
De Wet and his friends have taken to the hills to overthrow your government. Word has just come through. They've blown up your boat.
Good heavens! Pearl Harbor all over again.
Get Lombard over here right away. Use the hotline.
Check.
This is naked aggression by South Africa. I will not tolerate it. South African Embassy, get me the ambassador. Top priority. Thompson here.
Leave us alone!
African ambassador put developed to this.
Undoubtedly, sir.
We're faced with a serious situation. I must act swiftly. Thompson, what would you advise?
Well, speaking off the top of my head, Mr. Prime Minister, being such a strong and decisive leader as you are, I would immediately break off diplomatic relations with South Africa. Perhaps even declare war.
Exactly what I had in mind. Come in!
You wanted to see me, Mr. Prime Minister?
Lombard, we have tried hard to be good friends and neighbors of South Africa. Our policy has been one of peaceful coexistence. Yet despite all our efforts, you have openly connived and plotted against us.
But I don't understand, Mr. Prime Minister. What have we done now?
What have you done? Damn it, man, you've blown up my boat.
Blown up your what?
You leave me no alternative. As from now, diplomatic relations with South Africa are terminated.
But, Mr. Prime Minister...
I'm afraid, Lombard, this means war.
Makkelijker plek gekregen om weg te krijgen. Waar is Koos?
Generaal, de wet is in die kamp. Zo'n toe.
En die malligheid.
Falconet.
Ja, generaal.
Krijg elke roer slaggereed. En zorg dat elke man genoeg schietgoed heeft.
Ja, generaal.
En Falconet. Zijn voor die burger met zijn transistorradio die kies achter maken.
Ja, generaal. Wacht tot die eerste minister hiervan hoor, Koos.
Wat zoek je hier, Lombard?
Wat zoek jij hier?
Dit is aan mij oorgelaten om Zuid-Afrika's strijdfront te strijden.
Mijn eerste diplomatische zending en dit moet gebeuren. Jy weet wat so pas gebeur het, ne?
Ja, ek weet, my verkinders my ingelig. Bakleed oorlog verklaar teen Suid-Afrika.
En waarom? Omdat jy sy skuit opgeblaas het. Waarom jy sy skuit staan opgeblaas?
General De Wet.
Yes, Johnson.
They've just blown up Skulk Prinsloo's privy.
Was he inside?
No, General, he just finished.
So they've started with their dirty business, have they? Thank you, Johnson.
Daar is hier het, Lombard.
Sien jy daar nou al gebeur? Hierdie Buckley vind is skoon mal. Hy is al bezig om vreedsame burgers en hulle kleinhuisies aan te val.
Maar jy die hele ding begin? Dis jou skuld.
Wat maak het saak? Wat is die skuit in vergelijking met... Falconet, slul stik in die radio. Kijk, die Suid-Afrikaanse regering kan bang wees om te veg, maar ek is nie. Ons de wet sal toch nooit weghaal nie.
Koos, jy moet ophou met hierdie oorlogspelerij voor iemand seer kry.
Wat? Hulle het my in die parlement uitgeskop. Hulle het my seun uit die rugbyspan uitgejaag. En jy worry omdat iemand al kan seer kry.
Maar ek het jou gesê, die eerste minister wou dit diplomatisch gedoen he.
Die eerste minister sê... Kijk, dis nou tyd vir aksie. Vat die document van jou en kyk of jy hom geteken kan kry. Maar jy moet gauw maak, want die bloed gaan loop. En los my asseblief nou. Ek moet die strijd met eer volstry.
Koos my, ou maat. Jy neem die hele saak veelste ernstig op. Besef jy wat kan gebeur?
Besef ek wat kan gebeur? Die springboeken kan die reeks verloor, dis wat kan gebeur.
Well, our intelligence has established that the rebel forces are massing in the mountains in this sort of area here. We can expect De Wet to infiltrate using guerrilla tactics down through here. That's why I want you to plant your minefield right here. And don't forget to tell our chaps about it.
If I might suggest, Mr. Prime Minister, sir, while we're about it, why don't we blow up the bypass road, sir?
Well, certainly not. We need the bypass road for our own troop movements and armaments. And I want you to establish my field base here.
Command headquarters.
Any questions?
No, sir.
All right. Carry on.
Yes, sir. Washington on the line, sir.
Oh. Hello? Oh, hello, LBJ. Yes, I got your message. No need to panic, old man. I'm not negotiating any missile bases with Russia. Not at this stage, anyway. What? Well, thank you, LBJ. My regards to Ladybird. Thompson.
Charles, I'm late for my bridge game already.
I'm afraid there won't be time for bridge from now on, darling. Our country is at war. Command headquarters? Just a moment. Yes? Well, thank Chombi. Tell him it's a very kind offer, but we shan't be needing his mercenaries. Now, Thompson, I want you to take over the Ministry of Propaganda. You know, prepare the people for the hard times that lie ahead. Psychological warfare, all that sort of thing. You know?
Check, sir. I'll brainwash the people about food rationing, air raid precautions, blood transfusions.
No, that's right. Carry on, Thompson. Now then, darling. Margaret, as wife of the Prime Minister and Commander-in-Chief, you'll be expected to do your bit. I'd like you to take charge of the Women's Auxiliary Services. You'll hold the rank of colonel.
I will not be a party to your silly little war game.
In addition, Colonel, you will organize soup kitchens and make sure that the library is turned into a casualty station for the dying and the dead.
Charles, will you stop taking yourself so seriously? It's high time that you and Kurs got together and settled this whole thing. The sooner, the better.
I shall settle this on the battlefield.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Charles. Your Majesty.
Mrs. Buckley.
And please see that you're not late for dinner again tonight.
Yes, Murray. Your declaration of war came at a rather inopportune moment, you know. Caroline is in South Africa.
What on earth is she doing there?
She is spending the day at Clifton Beach with Farney.
Well, get her back again. We can't have our princess in enemy territory. Get on to Lombard.
We've severed diplomatic relations, remember? And in any case, I don't think we should be at war with South Africa.
Oh, nonsense. Ask yourself, Murray, would you like your daughter to marry a South African? Hello? Whose aunt? Oh, Mr. Utant. Yes, yes, well, I'm well aware of the United Nations Charter, but I'm not open to peace negotiations at this time. Yes, yes, we shan't forget our membership fees, Mr. Utant. Good day. Yes, Caroline, yes. Well, tell Sergeant Van der Vesthuizen. He'll get her back from Clifton.
Oh, Princess. You've got to come home right away. Written instructions from Sergeant Van der Westhuizen.
Why? What's happened?
Oh, nothing serious. Sellendam has declared war on South Africa.
War? But why?
Who knows? But you've got to come now. You better come. Come on.
Bye, everyone. See you after the war.
Bye. Cheers. Bye.
Therefore, I know that I can rely upon the fortitude of my people to stand together as one. They will stand with their shoulders to the grindstone and their noses to the wheel and push. And I only hope nobody gets hurt. Please be terribly careful, won't you?
Thank you, Your Majesty.
The idea is to inspire them, not to frighten them to death.
Fellow countrymen, the time has come. We must steel ourselves to fight for our country and our king, and fight we shall. We shall fight them in the streets and in the copies. We shall fight them in the fields and in the dongas. We shall never surrender. And if there be those among you today who are not prepared to lay down your lives, to die if necessary, then go home now. Never have so many owed so much to so few. Murray, call the cabinet, will you?
Yes, Mr. Prime Minister. Bye-bye.
General!
Ja, commandant.
General, as a vrouw mens in die kamp.
Jy kan me bevelen. Geen vrouw mens wordt toegelaten tijdens actieve dienst nie. Wat denk je is het die? Is een kinderkamp? Raak ons slavenaar. Zet haar man op rapport.
Het is die eie vrouw, generaal. Zij dring aan om met u te praten.
Mijn vrouw? Wel, ik kan geen uitzondering wees niet. Dit geldt voor die leier ook. Ik wil niet met haar praten. Stuur haar weg.
Ja, generaal. Die generaal wil niet met u praten.
Koos, krijg nou eind met hierdie nonsens en luister naar mij.
Commandant!
Generaal!
Begeleid hier die vrouw mee en sy die kamp uit. Dadelijk.
Kom vrou mens, uit die kamp uit.
Hey, van der Merwe. Jy praat nie met my vrou so nie, hoor.
Ja, generaal.
Koos, wanneer hou julle nou op bliksoldaatjie speel, hm?
Kom dan.
Generaal!
Herinner hierdie vrou mens, sy praat met die gorilla van die generale leer. Met die generaal van die gorilla leer.
Hy sê jy praat met die generaal van die gorilla leer.
Koos, ek is bekommerd oor jou. Jy het 'n week nie gebad nie en jy het jou sooibrandpilletjies ook by die huis vergeet.
Wat? Wat? Ek sal bad wanneer die bloed van die vijand van my hande afgewas word. Syveraar.
Bad, bad! Ek sal bad wanneer die vijand sy bloed van my hande afwas.
Wie se bloed gaan aan jou hande wees? Buckley, Hendrik, Caroline, gaan julle allemaal doodmaak?
Die wat in my pad staan, sy bloed sal vloei in die strate van Stellendam.
Die wat in my pad staan, sy bloed sal vloei in die strate...
Shut up, van der Merwe!
Generaal!
Margaret het met Buckley gereel dat ons saam gaan eet, julle die saak kan bespreek en dat hierdie nonsens nou kan end kry.
So nou wil Buckley voor my kruip. Hy wil smeek om genade. Nooit! Commandant!
Generaal!
Haal my pille!
Generaal, maar hulle is oor die kraans!
Commandant!
Generaal!
Die ete is gereel vir vanavond en jy kom.
Ek sal eerder in die berge krepeer van die honger. Die aasvoels kan my bene wit pik as om saam met die jakkels in die selde tafel te sit. My antwoord is nee.
Are you two still sulking?
You can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink.
Well, you two horses haven't been doing badly.
And we're not going to start dinner until you've become friends. So why don't you go into the library and settle your differences?
Yes, come along, Puss.
Go on.
Come on. And you're not coming out until you've finished your peace talks.
And remember, no quarreling. And certainly no shouting.
All right, no shouting. Now look here, Devitt.
Shh.
Yes. I've been thinking.
I know. My wife's been speaking to me, too.
Yes, well, we can't allow all this bloodshed and killing.
You're quite right, Charles. War can be a terrible thing. Sit down, Buckley.
No, thanks. I'd rather stand. You know, Yvette, I've been through all this before. All the killing, the carnage, the bloodshed. Oh, you wouldn't understand.
What do you mean? I wouldn't understand. We, the vets, have been fighting in bloody wars for hundreds of years.
You have?
Mayuba, Spionko, Mafeking.
Oh, yes, Mafeking.
Merrifield.
Yes, we gave you a belting there, didn't we?
What do you mean you gave me a belting? Gorets.
Of course. We've got to settle this matter.
You're quite right, Charles. Nobody wants a war.
But if you surrender, I guarantee that you won't get shot as a rebel.
Charles, if you don't surrender by dawn, I'll attack. Sorry, Charles.
It's all right. It's quite all right. You must lay down your arms or I'll have to destroy you.
But, Charles, remember Mayuba.
You remember Mafeking.
Mafeking. Erica! Buckley, I'll get you for this, you... Erica! Open this door! Erica! Oh, thank you, Charles. Erica, come on, slow
to... But, Makirkus!
Where's Erica? Oh, where have you been?
To know, Kus, to know.
For heaven's
sake,
Charles.
Come on,
slow face,
too. Was it not here to eat? Oscar, please,
oh, Charles, you've ruined my dinner.
I'm sorry, my dear, but Kuss and I are going to war in the morning. Isn't that right, Kuss?
We're going to war in the morning. Oh, what a beautiful war.
Enemy forces, sir. What's that? Enemy forces approaching, sir!
Ek hoor die vijand. Hulle doodle.
everybody, at once! It's the enemy! Skid! Nee, wacht, moet niet skid nie. De soos mensen, Erika, wat was ik hier dan? Van de Merwe, kom er aan! Wat zijn jullie zo verschrikt, die klop vrouw mensen? Voorwaarts! Erika, af van die slagveld af! Campbell, get your men through! Get them through immediately! Forward, voorwaarts allemaal! Erika, ik krijg je op die ijs hoor! Ik krijg je op die ijs! Voorwaarts allemaal! Ice front! There's a time for everything! This is war!
Beautifully sung, ladies. Very nice indeed, Margaret. Thank you. Now, if you excuse me, Mrs. Johnson, Mrs. Silva, thank you. Excuse me.
Stinker.
Squadron!
I'll be home for dinner.
Forward!
For the young candy bear, so ask the prince to last up for the young candy bear.
So it's none of our business.
But you can't just sit here and ignore it, Dad. They'll kill each other.
I've already spoken to Mr. Buckley. He insists on war.
But you're the king, Hendrik. They'll have to listen to you.
Look. As king, I wasn't even consulted about going to war. I've decided to wash my hands of the whole matter.
Well, if you won't try and stop it, I will.
Don't you go near them, Caroline. You'll get hurt.
Are you coming, Dad?
As though I haven't got enough to do already.
Jullie, waar is hier achter die knop?
Oi, now we can surprise them.
Storm! Hold Buckley! Stop that noise! Hold Buckley! Buckley het weghaal! Van de Merwe!
Generaal!
Skrap hier die doodlers! En een ons volg die vijand!
Don't move! Put down your guns or you'll be shot!
We've been ambushed, General!
Buckley, that's a dirty trick!
Ah, fell into my trap, eh, Devet? Lay down your arms!
No, don't lay them down, lift them up, ready to fire! Now, Buckley, you lay down your arms or I'll blast you to kingdom come.
Put down your guns or I'll wipe you out.
Ready to fire. Buckley, I demand your surrender.
You capitulate immediately or I'll destroy you. No, don't shoot. Well, hold it, Ben.
Sorry, Devet, it went off accidentally. You all right?
It's all right, thank you, Charles. Now, for the last time, surrender or we fire.
My patience Stop. Is exhausted. Prepare for action, men.
Stop! Don't shoot! This game Maldivet! You can't shoot each other! We all South Africans!
Oh, good heavens! The shooting started. Let's go home.
Please, Dad, you've got to stop them.
Oh, and easy lies the head that wears a crown.
Buckley, for the 10th time, I'm warning you to surrender.
And I'm warning you, Devet. I can't hold back my men any longer.
Van der Merwe, word slaggereed.
Ons is slaggereed, generaal.
Nope, blees slaggereed.
Ja, generaal.
Buckley.
Oh, Murray, for heaven's sake, get out of the line of fire.
There will be no bloodshed. I'm commanding you to lay down your arms.
Get back to your office, Murray.
I am your king and you will obey me. Put down those weapons.
And I'm the prime minister and I refuse.
You are no longer prime minister. You're fired. I'll appoint a new prime minister.
You wouldn't, Murray.
Mr. O'Flaherty.
Sir.
Will you be my prime minister and lay down your arms?
Well, no, thank you, sir. It'll be a great honor.
Well, if you don't, there's no need for that.
Lay down your arms.
Will you hear what the king said? I don't need guns.
Well, Buckley, looks as if we got you at last, eh?
I'll fight you with my bare hands if necessary. Go ahead, hide behind your guns like cowards.
Coward? Me, a coward? Mana, lay near your weapons. Buckley, I'll fight you with one hand tied behind my back. Van der Merwe, hou me vast. En moet niet mij los nie, als zij voor je los mij. Los mij. Nee, moet niet mij los nie, wil jij ik ben hij maar vermoor.
Men, prepare for hand-to-hand combat.
Van der Merwe, los mij.
Of course, it's no use. The war is over, and we've let South Africa down.
What do you mean I've let South Africa down?
Well, Stellendam is still independent.
No. I've got plans. Plenty of plans I want to talk to you about. Officier, scrum. Capture the town hall!
Come on, get moving!
Mr. Prime Minister, sir, they're making for the town hall.
Whatever for?
Well, that's our seat of government, sir. If De Wet captures that, he'll be in power.
Charge!
Town hall, men, let's get there first.
Faith shields out!
Don't let the rebels through!
I'll do my best, Mr. Prime Minister.
Come on up!
You'll have to betale, you'll have to deal gone.
Steer a reckoning, man.
Come on, you'll have to deal with it. You can deal with the hospital. Oh, careful! Show your passport!
Hey!
Stop!
General.
Burgers, forward!
Come on, fellas! Keep ahead of them!
Come on, forward!
General.
General, come to move!
That's all!
Good.
Way for the Verba! Von der Verba!
Don't let the rebels pass you!
Opskirt, Carlos. Folk of Fatherland. Abram, Statsal 2. Faster, Buckley! You'll break the sound barrier! Buckley! That's another dirty trick! Abraham! Frugger!
All right, thank you, attention. Carry on. To the town hall, fast. Move. Come on, let's get aboard.
Wait for me. Wait. They've grabbed the fire engine. Abra, race for the Kumdari hook and sneak them off.
Mr. Prime Minister.
What? Oh, jolly good. Spend. Thank you.
General Wet, kom! Onze Engelse generaal op hok.
Van der Merwe! You traitor!
Muy so, Commandant.
De Wet! This isn't cricket!
Well, Buckley, looks like you've blown up your last privy, eh?
Where?
Whore, nothing, yo, blickscuttle! De Wet?
Clamp this tyrant in chains!
De Wet, I demand the protection of the Geneva Convention!
Ach, man! Round up the rest of them! I'll deal with this one later!
De Wet! Let me out of here!
Ah, SABC? Thompson here, take a statement. I emphatically deny the malicious rumor that the brave...
Thompson!
I've just overthrown your government.
There's been a slight change. I'll call you back. Well, congratulations, Mr. DeVette. You said put a stick of dynamite under them, wake them up a bit. You were right. Well, we gave them something to think about, eh? Great publicity.
Mr. Bernadette.
Corporal.
Sheriff.
Arrest this South African immediately. Put him against a wall and shoot him.
Oh, Mr. Bernadette. Think of the bad publicity. I've got influential friends. They won't like this. Neither will I. I'm too young to die. Leave me alone. Help.
Mr. Lombard to see you, of course.
Mooi skoot, Koos. A wonderlike sege. Ons het hulle so ware punt of twee gewys.
Wel, ja, Lombard.
Groot nuus, Koos. Die eerste minister het jou regering erken en nog 'n ding, die keurde sê Fanny kan vanmiddag speel as jy net gou hierdie dokument teken.
Jy word diplomaties gehad, hè, Lombard?
Dis wat die eerste minister wou hê, ja.
My complimente aan jou eerste minister. Sê vir hom as leier van die onafhanklike staat Stellendam, weier ek om te teken.
Ja, dis 'n goeie daai, Koos. Dis mos wat maklik gesê het.
Nou sê ek dit. En ek is die leier.
Maar Koos, jy kan nie ernstig wees nie. Wat van die rugby? Suid-Afrika, jou seun nodig.
En Stellendam met sy pa nodig.
But Koos, we are world champions. Without Fanny, we lose this rugby series.
I'm sorry, I cannot equate a game of rugby with the destiny of my country. And you may go, Campbell.
Koos, die eerste minister gaan woedend wees.
Jy kan ook loop, Lombard. Ek het staatsake wat my aandag verg.
De Wet, jy draai teen jou land. Jy's 'n verraaier. Jy verkoop jou mense vir 'n bordjie lensiesop.
Generaal, ek het Buckley en sy hele kabinet op hok geslaan. Hulle is langsaam.
Van der Merwe, hy's mal. Hy wil nie teken nie. Sê vir hom. Ag, asseblief, ou Koos, teken tog. Ek kan nie teruggaan na die eerste minister
toe. Kommandant!
Generaal!
Hierdie Suid-Afrikaner pla my. Ek neem hom net en smyt ons saam met die ander en skiet die boel met dagbreek.
Maar ons dan agter Suid-Afrikaners.
Van der Merwe, wil jy geskiet raak?
Kom, Dutchman.
Jy kan my nie laat skiet in die Wet. Ek eis diplomatieke beskerming.
Staan daar, meneer Resnelle. You're all going to be shot at dawn. General's orders.
What do you mean? Oh,
what about that?
I believe it.
Is this true, Lombard?
Yes, De Wet's power mad. You were bad enough, Buckley, but he's become a dictator. You'll all be living under the heel of a Castro.
You'd hardly be living if we're going to be shot at dawn. De Wet's lost his marbles.
Be careful what you say. You'll get into trouble.
I even told him his son could play with the Springboks this afternoon, and he still refused to sign. That proves he's mad.
Well, that settles it, gentlemen. We shall have to rejoin South Africa. It's our only hope.
Oh, what about the bypass road? South Africa will open it again.
We're going to be shot at dawn, O'Flaherty. Who cares about the bypass road?
In any case, you can't rejoin until De Wet signs.
Then I'll have to make him sign.
You? How?
It's quite simple. Leave it to me.
Commandant!
Generaal!
Stel hulle familie en kennis van die terechtstelling.
Generaal!
En moet nie die kerkhof vergeet.
Generaal!
Lombard.
Die gaan nie hiermee wegkom nie, Koos.
Well, Buckley. Well, Buckley, it seems you've reached the end of the road.
My dear, of course. I heartily endorse your magnificent decision to preserve the dignity and independence of our great state of Stellendam.
Oh, thank you, Charles.
Who cares whether or not the Springboks win the present series?
Buckley.
Who cares whether or not the All Blacks become world champions?
Buckley.
Rugby, it's a silly game. It's not important.
It is important. Don't you talk about rugby like that.
My dear, of course. You wouldn't seriously consider signing this document?
I'll sign anything I wish. I'm the leader. If I wish to sign this document, I'll sign it.
De Wet, I command you not to sign that document.
You command? Here you die, document. He commands me. Me, delayer.
I take a net out as a big pen. Pen, ja, natuurlijk, pen. Dit is pen.
Here, here. De Wet, I forbid you to sign.
No forbid him, eh?
Net daar, zo.
Lombard.
Ja, generaal?
Wat van kaartjes?
Kaartjes?
Voor die rugby, man.
Ja, nee, ek sal sorg dat generaal twee kry.
Ek wil 100 kaartjes hê vir my getroue burgers of anders geen inlewing nie.
Maar die prys is te hoog, dis uitverkoop. Dis die vierde toets.
As I said, De Wet, don't you sign.
50 kaartjes.
Maar goed, ons hulle paviljoen ontruim. Enigiets, maar teken net daar, asseblief.
De Wet.
Dankie, Koos, dankie.
Gentlemen, I have fulfilled my vow.
Koos,
to incorporate Stel...
Koos, net voor jy begin preek, laat ons hierdie saak afhandel, asseblief. Murray, will you sign here too, please?
Let me, Murray, will you sign here too, please?
Hy is koning, hy is staatshoof, hy moet ons ook teken.
As king, it has fallen upon my shoulders to uphold the independence of Stellendam. I refuse to sign.
Go on, Hendrik, and take dadelijk hierdie document.
After we've gone to all this trouble?
Murray, sign the flipping document.
Oh, all right.
Sign that, please.
Firing squad! Down!
Thompson! Stop the execution!
And as leader of the Revolutionary Council, I feel it is my duty to uphold the independence of Stellendam. Thank you, men. Camel?
General!
Is the firing squad ready?
Yes, General.
Then arrest General De Wet immediately.
Aye, aye, sir.
Stop!
Stop the execution! Don't shoot! What's going on here?
This is a coup d'etat. A counter-revolution to counter the counter-revolution.
What?
All right, Thompson. Well, there's no need for any of that. You see, we've just signed incorporation back into South Africa.
I'm the leader here now. Incorporation cancelled. Campbell?
Sir.
Put this man up against the wall and shoot him as a traitor.
Aye, aye, sir.
Will you go shoot me? What? We're all South Africans. We're friends, Campbell, Erica, Susan. We're neighbors.
Goodbye, Kuss.
Goodbye. Goodbye!
Fire squad! Ready!
Aim!
Hold it! Hold it! If De Wet goes, I go too.
Buckley, will you stop interfering? If anybody dies, I die.
I started this whole thing. It's my show.
Who won this war? I'm the leader.
Well, never mind about that. We die together.
Gamble. Shoot. Quickly.
What? What? Courtney's? What's good? Courtney's in here. Come. In my cabinet, possibly.
Buckley, did you hear that? I'm a cabinet minister.
My heartiest congratulations. Too late.
Oh. On a matter of... Kom hier saam met jou leier sterf.
Nee, dankie, Koos. Nie vandag nie. Ek gaan rugby toe.
Rugby. Oh. Rugby.
Right, Campbell. Carry on.
Ready?
Shoot straight. And shoot true. Through the colors over my heart.
Our heart.
All right, our heart.
I'm sorry, Thompson. I cannot fire on the Springbok colors.
What do you mean, Springbok colors? Think of the publicity value.
Alles is recht, mensen. I've arranged seats for everybody.
Lombard, you don't understand. This is a counter-revolution.
Oh, shut up, Thompson. We're late already.
Right, men, we're off to rugby.
I'm a Campbell.
Call in, men. Boom, burger.
My revolution. Campbell, you're fired. I'm the leader now. Listen, I forbid you to go to rugby.
Your Majesty.
To Newlands! And victory!
Now the slagveld! Voor Bergh!